Hey guys, blood pressure measurements consist of two numbers that can indicate your risk of heart attack and stroke. Depending on your age, there may be free services available to measure your blood pressure, like a local pharmacy or by speaking to your GP. Alternatively, you can purchase a home blood pressure monitor. First, let's quickly run through what the two numbers mean. When you get a blood pressure reading, it will look something like this, though hopefully with smaller numbers. This blood pressure reading is 140 over 80. 140 is your systolic pressure. It's the force of your heart pumping blood around your body. 80 is your diastolic pressure, which is the pressure in your arteries between heartbeats. And it's always going to be lower than the first number. This chart can vary by organization and country, but this is an example of how blood pressure might be categorized. So you're reading your first number on the vertical axis, then the second number on the horizontal axis. So let's plot 140 over 80. In this case, 140 is on the verge of hypertension, which is the medical term for high blood pressure, while 80 is the upper limit of normal. Blood pressure is slightly higher in men than in women of the same age. That is true right up until menopause, when the women end up eventually overtaking the men. There is also a trend for it to rise with age, but that may be preventable with a healthy diet and lifestyle. Okay, onto the measurement. Here I'm using an at-home blood pressure cuff and monitor. The British Heart Foundation website has a shop which stocks reliable brands including A&D, Microlife and Omron. This one is an Omron M2 Basic and it costs about £25. The UK's National Health Service recommends a device with an upper arm cuff like this, as opposed to some devices which measure based on the finger or wrist. To get the most accurate reading, there is quite a big list of things I will and won't do beforehand. I want to avoid eating, exercising or smoking in the 30 minutes before measurement. I want to sit upright in a chair with back support, with feet flat on the floor, relaxed, and I want to be seated for a few minutes before measuring. I'll use an appropriately sized cuff, measure both arms with no clothing between the cuff and my skin, and if I really want to be sure, I'll measure on several non-consecutive days to handle any natural fluctuations. So here is a quick demonstration.
So you just have to have awareness of how you put the sleeve on, which is roughly two fingers from the elbow joint, and then tight enough that you can't put fingers underneath it too easily. Then it's as simple as putting your hand down and then just pressing the button. Left arm is 112 over 75, pulse is apparently 50.
I've been tracking my blood pressure for around 9 years and I tend to sit around 115 over 70, which is the high end of normal. If you are healthy and in range, then measuring yourself once a year is a great starting point. If your blood pressure is above 120 over 80, you should be speaking to your GP and getting advice from them about monitoring frequency. This is only really a tutorial for how to measure and interpret your results, but I will quickly cover lifestyle interventions. Your chances of having high blood pressure increase if you have a diet high in salt, smoke, drink a lot of alcohol, drink a lot of caffeine, don't exercise, and you are overweight or obese. Therefore, to lower your blood pressure, you can reduce dietary salt, quit smoking, reduce alcohol and caffeine intake, increase the amount of exercise you do, and reduce your body fat levels. If you don't know your blood pressure, regardless of whether you have any symptoms or not, it's absolutely worth getting yourself checked. It's probably one of the most important health measurements that you can have done. Thanks for watching.